why the Netherlands is bigger than it should be. If you think you've experienced your share of wet weather, try living in the Netherlands. To call it wet would be a massive understatement. Over one quarter of the Netherlands is below sea level, and almost 70% is vulnerable to flooding. Three of Europe's major rivers, the Rhine, Maas, and Scheldt rivers, all run through the Netherlands. The northern and western parts of the Netherlands connect with the North Sea. But the Dutch don't panic. Ever since the 14th century, they have experimented with and developed highly effective systems of water management that has resulted in much of the land being reclaimed from the sea. In fact, about 17% of the Netherlands' current landmass has been the result of land reclamation. Such is their expertise that the Dutch are widely regarded as world leaders when it comes to water management. Through trial, error, and constant innovation, they have transformed the Netherlands into a secure and flood-safe region that would have been previously uninhabitable. Water has always been at the forefront in the Netherlands. The Roman author Pliny the Elder was far from impressed during his time there and declared the area to be a pitiful place that floods twice a day. The Dutch were to show more fortitude than classical scholars, and by the 14th century were making serious progress towards reclaiming the land. The Netherlands is a largely flat landform that was once mainly swamps and lakes. Sediment deposits from floods over the years created a plain that was eventually inhabited by settlers who were all too wary of the imminent danger of floods. In around 400 BC, the original settlers opted for building terps, which were artificial mounds upon which settlements could be constructed. Many of these terps can still be seen today, and they are the easiest evidence of the Dutch attempts to control the flow of water within the country. Terps were typically 10 to 15 meters high and could be effective in protecting against floods from the North Sea or rivers. They also began building simple dikes to separate farming land from water. Dikes are walls or barriers with water on one side and land on the other. Their purpose is to protect the land that would otherwise be flooded. These early dikes were no higher than 1 meter and were built with peat and whatever came to hand. Peat is partially decomposed vegetation and organic matter, and it formed the basis of the Netherlands' first dikes. Terps and dikes were used throughout Roman occupation until 400 AD, and then into the medieval period. The areas of land protected by dikes are known as polders, and they are a distinct feature of the landscape in the Netherlands. In the medieval years, the Dutch first created polders by building dikes to ward off water flows. The next step was to drain the polders of excess water, which they did by building tiny canals that led to rivers or the ocean. This kept the land dry, making it suitable to either live on or farm. In 1287, pressure from the North Sea proved too much for the terps and dikes, and the Netherlands was flooded. The St. Lucia's flood was one of the biggest ever recorded and claimed the lives of over 50,000 people. This tragedy led to the determined pursuit of innovative water management. By the early 14th century, windmills started being used to pump water from polders. The process was simple. First, the windmill used its natural energy harnessed by winds to turn the wheel rotors. This in turn would cause a pump inside a pipe to go up and down. The pump used a plunger to suck water up and into the pipe. From here, the water was either discharged into a storage tank or diverted to a river. Canals and sluice gates were also critical in controlling the flow of water. Once a polder was created, a network of canals were then installed in order to keep the water moving. Water was released from the polder canals by sluice gates, which controlled the water flow to rivers or storage tanks. Such a system is still in use today. The development of windmill pumps, intricate canals, and gates meant the Dutch could now drive vast areas of land, creating huge polders. The first notable such creation was the Beemster Polder, where an entire lake was drained and dried from 1609 to 1612 with the use of windmill pumps. The Beemster Polder reclaimed an area of roughly 70 kilometers squared, which is slightly smaller than the city of Copenhagen. As water management expertise grew, the Netherlands embarked on the damming of potential flood areas. One of the most famous of these projects is the Zuiderzee Works, which was a massive operation to dam an inlet from the North Sea in 1932. The Zuiderzee, meaning South Sea in Dutch, was a bay that ran some 100 kilometers inland. It was 50 meters wide, but only about 10 meters deep. While it was an important source for fishing and wildlife, the Zuiderzee could be hazardous and susceptible to mass flooding. North Sea storms could send water spilling out of the bay and potentially killing thousands. In the early 20th century, plans were put in motion to dam the Zuiderzee, despite its huge expense. The key feature of the project was building the main dam, which was 32 kilometers long and 7 meters above sea level. The dam was raised by a mixture of sand, clay, and boulders. The Zuiderzee project not only provided greater safety from floods for the Netherlands, but also brought plenty of agricultural opportunities with this new, fertile land. In 1953, the North Sea flood devastated parts of England, Scotland, Belgium, and the Netherlands. Over 1,800 Dutch were killed when a vicious storm sent North Sea water crashing over coastal defences and flooding the Zeeland province. This prompted swift action from authorities, and a massive defensive program was initiated, known as the Delta Works. The Delta Works' main aim was to shorten the Dutch coastline and transform much of the Zeeland region into lakes. The Zeeland region was especially vulnerable to flooding as a series of rivers met at the North Sea. Work commenced in 1959 and was finally finished in 1997. It included an incredible 13 dams, as well as another 300 structures, such as dikes, levees, and gates. The Delta Works reflected the change in thinking of Dutch engineering, as they focused more on dams instead of dikes. Dams were seen as stronger and safer options to protect the mainland from North Sea flooding. The Delta project also led to the construction of the Maaslandkering at the port of Rotterdam. The Maaslandkering is a gigantic storm barrier consisting of two gates that close and block out any water in the case of floods. Each gate is about 240 meters in length. It is a classic example of how the Netherlands have been able to continually revise and improve their systems of water management. Today, Dutch engineers are sought after around the world for their expert insights and advice, from Northern Africa to the United States and Southeast Asia. The Netherlands and water have always been inextricably linked. It is a testament to the Dutch resourcefulness and determination that the country has so much land on which to live. People have learned not to fight water, but to manage it and live with it.